Vagishajasya badane Lakshmir yasacha bakshasi Yasyasthi de sambhid Vam Nishinamaham Bhaji. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Honor be the Jading Jirat Corona, Vatirna Kalu. Samarpati unnato ujjvalarasam sabakti sram Harihi purata sundara dhuti kadam basan nivita Sadahidai gandhari spurutu vasi sachinandana Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told for actual bhajan to engage all common people in actual Hari Bhajan, I was bound to put them into anxiety. I give them trouble. For that I beg for pardon. Anyway, they misunderstood me for this activity. I repeatedly told what is the duty of Gauriya Math. What is the actual duty of Gauriya Math? I told repeatedly before, you can remember. Those who are going here and there to bring them and put them in actual Hari Bhajan, it is the actual unpleasant duty of Gauriya Math. To arrest the current perverted tide, to arrest the current perverted tide is the seemingly unpleasant duty of Gauriya Math. Prabhupada repeatedly speaking, I was bound to speak absolute truth. I know they cannot tolerate that kind of naked truth. But what to do? To engage them in actual Hari Bhajan, I was bound to put them in trouble. For that I beg for pardon. But anyway, they misunderstood me. Someday they can understand me rightly, that what was my actual duty. If they can understand, they can be very satisfied with me, what to do. Actually, Prabhupada repeatedly speaking, there is two type of darshan. One is Vedodrik, Vedodrik means if you are enjoying full kippa of parampara, you can develop one kind of darshan, that is Vedodrik. Vedodrik means Veda and Bhagavatam, all scripture giving you backing to rectify your darshan, I mean clear darshan, as it is. At present, what you are seeing everywhere, it is not as it is. What you are watching everywhere, at present, that darshan is not at all perfect darshan. It is not as it is darshan. Srila Rupa Goswami, Srila Sanatana Goswami, Jiva Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Gopal Bhatt Goswami, you know, they are having this kind of pure darshan. That is called as it is darshan. All our Guru Varga, Prabhupada, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, they can see perfectly what is there. But there is another kind of darshan, that is Mangshodrik. Is with a feeling of blood and flesh. Jaha jaha netto pare taha rakta mangshaspure. Wherever I look, I can see there is blood and flesh, shape and design. I like to see. Oh, this design is very bad. But you forget this shape and design, this beauty or handsomeness, everything what you are watching every fraction of second is not going to stay here in this material world. You are also going to go away from this material world. Actually, if somebody is speaking all rubbish against one pure Vaishnava, he never become angry. Why? Because he is speaking all rubbish. This world is not permanent, temporary. Who is passing this kind of remark is not permanent. Situation is not permanent. So why should I become angry? On the contrary, I would say those pure devotees, they become very happy if somebody pass all absurd remark, ugly remark about them. They become very happy. Because people cannot come to them, they can find sufficient time to do Hari Bhajan, you know, consented. Though I know it is also one kind of bhajan, speaking Harikatha. Prabhupada speaking, this is number one Harikatha. Number one bhajan mode, actually. So, Mansakdrik and Vedadrik. Prabhupada used to say that there is a gulf difference between this material world and transcendental world. There is a gulf difference between this material world and transcendental world. That gulf is infinity, you can say, and full of blood and flesh. This conception. Prabhupada speaking, if you get one straight line, suppose one point is there, just there is one line touching that point in center. And from that center, if you try to get circle, you can get first some equitangle create, then after that more and more, after that 90 degree, after that 90 cross, then it is touching horizontal line 180. Then again, if the like clockwise is going on, if original point when it started, it touches, then it becomes 360 angle. Point is there, one clock round, then you can see it is clock round, it is called 360 degree angle. 360 degree angle, though this example is not perfect, I think so, but still, Popa speaking this way, those who are pure Vaishnava, they can see anything what is what, they can see. There is no impediment. But when you want to see anything, I told you yesterday, there is one kind of magical spell of Maya. Maya, they be acting, it stop you to see the perfect thing. That's why you should sing Kulo Devi Jogumaya More Kipa Kori Avaron Sangbirube Tumi Vishwadori. There is one screen, so I cannot get in touch with that Supreme Lord. Parampuja Santu Goswami Maharaj used to give one nice example. Also, I quote this example. He used to say, see, my son, there is one very, very pure honey, Padma Madhu, from lotus flower, he collected special. So flavor alone, if you put the honey here, all surrounding place become very, very nice fragrant smell. Oh. And all those honeybees, they are bound to come. They are going to come. Maharaj saying that Padma Madhu, that honey, special Madhu, is just kept inside one glass bottle. Glass bottle. All honeybees, they are coming, flying over around, hovering around. But they are also trying to lick this honey. But they cannot get in touch with that honey because glass screen is there. Santu Goswami Maharaj used to give this same example. Same thing, Prabhupada used to speak. That's why we cannot get in touch with that absolute truth, I mean that nectar, which is there, and the lotus feet of Chaitanya Chandra and Nityananda. I quoted in Puri also, I can remember what I am speaking there. I told sometime, Sri Chaitanya Padam Bhajo Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. Kathanchit asrayat jesam swa upi tad gandhabhag bhavet. Sri Chaitanya padam bhujo madhupebhyo namo namaha. Kathanchit asrayat jesam swa upi tad gandhabhag bhavet. those who are honeybees, they are hovering around the lotus feet of Chaitanya Charan, they are very nectar, nice. They are getting flavor, so they are running around, even hovering around, and they are being, this kind of sound is Sankirtan. They are doing Sankirtan around, getting touch with, get the nectar. Sri Chaitanya Padam Bhujo Madhupibho Namo Namaha, that's Madhupibho is plural number. Madhupibho means those are honeybees. That means our Guru Varga. Honeybees who? Honeybees? There's honeybees, they are our Guru Varga. All our Guru Varga, Rup, Raghunath, they are honeybees. They are on our Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they are honeybees. And yesterday I told you one example. You started laughing yesterday. What example? I told everybody knows in flower honey is there. But you have no power to get honey out of that. If you get a big amount of flour from market or from garden, and in grinder you paste, you cannot get even a drop. You will have to depend upon honeybees. So honeybees, those are Guru Varga, you will have to depend. And regarding Bhakti Kripa, I told you one day ago, not yesterday, one day ago. The Bhakti Kripa, to grow Bhakti Kripa in your heart, you need one kind of support. Be careful, be sincere. To grow that Bhakti Kripa, you need one kind of support. What that support mean? If that support is breakable, if the support, you cannot believe for permanent prior, temporary, then you are going to meet trouble. You must depend upon one's support. What does it mean? Support means Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava. Pure Guru Vaishnava. Those who are no touch with any material thing, you can test them. Prabhupada make 64 different Gauriya Marsal about this all around the world. But still Prabhupada is Niskinchan, nothing touching in his heart. Somebody passing this kind of regard, Prabhupada, you are making 64 math within the short period, Prabhupada said, what do you speak? I'm very sorry, you are speaking like that? I like to establish Gauriya Marsal inside the heart of everybody. See, he was speaking, what about 64 months? It's nothing. I like to establish Gauriya Marsal inside the heart of all Jivatma. So you see the mercy of Prabhupada. So this is the main, thing. That's all of our Guru Varga, they are honeybees, you will have to depend upon them. If you cut relation with them, then you are not going to get anything, no power, you cannot get. Again, if the link is very poor, sometimes you say power connection is poor, very poor, not current not coming properly. That is also dangerous. And at all there is no connection, that is also dangerous. I mean, you depend upon somebody who is not at all in connection with that. Vishayashakta chittyanam krishna avesho sudurataha. Parambuja Sridhar Goswami Maharaj used to give one nice example. What that example is? One lotus flower is there in a pond, very nice lake. Very nice lake. There is very, very nice lotus flower. There is nice water. Very nice looking. Parambuja Sridhar Goswami Maharaj speaking, that flower is very beautiful to look. And with sunrise, the beauty of flower again more and more, expressed. With sunrise, they express themselves in full-fledged form, blossom. That time, the beauty is totally different. No? But Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami Maharaj speaking, suppose that Padma leaving the support of water, water gone. Dry season, no water there. That flower is there. That lotus flower is there. But too much dryness. Now that lotus flower not getting the support of water. Previously, sunlight giving support. Sunlight was very soothing, very, you know, suitable for that lotus flower because water is under the, you know, support of water. Now, if water gone, in that case, that very lotus flower, scorchy sunlight can burn it up. Follow my point. You follow, get my point, what I say. That very flower is there, lotus flower, but now there is no support of water. Same sun is there, as scorchy sunlight, putting heavy, you know, sunlight, but that flower cannot resist it. It's just burnt up. Similar way, Paramahansa Siddhartha Goswami want to prove this point. If those jivatma leave the support of Guru Vaishnava, I mean, leave the support of water, that same Krishna is there, but Krishna cannot support you. You can give so, you know, tap, it is called, you know, misery. Tap, it is called misery. It can burn you up, you can die. Your spiritual life totally dead. So, don't become angry with me, because Prabhupada told to arrest the current perverted tide is a seemingly unpleasant duty of Gauriyamad. So I am also bound to speak that thing. Because today is the topmost day when I can preach about Gauriyamad and Prabhupada. That is the glory of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Gauranga Mahaprabhu took birth here, went there, this, that, I can speak. But this actual philosophy, darshan, today is the topmost peak hour when I have the opportunity to preach loudly all about the Gauriya Siddhanta of Prabhupada, to get the full kripa of Gauranga. There's a topmost peak prayer, you see. But in Chaitanya Charitamrita, one point you can find, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can find one point, you can start fighting with me, because in Chaitanya Charitamrita, one point is there, Kai mono bakke kare udbigna dibe. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can find one verse there. Kai mone bakke kare udbigna dibe. By body or by mind. Kai mon bakyo or by speech. You have no right to give pain to anybody. It is written there, Chaitanya Charitamrita. Kaimono bakye kare udbeg na dibe. Very vital point. Physically, mentally, you can, though you are physically not giving any punishment of pain, but mental torture you are doing. You cannot do. Kaimono bakye, by speech, also you cannot give pain to others. But this point is so vital, which is only applicable for Haridas Thakur, Sanatana, Rup. But when in our parampara, all our Guru Varga like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Kesava Goswami, they are speaking all hard. Parampara Bhakti Vaibhava Puri Goswami is very hard. Then you can speak, they are breaking the rules. It is written there in Chaitanya Charitamrita, not to give any pain to anybody. They are speaking so harsh. So they are breaking rules. No, not that. That's why, you know, it is written, Kayamono Bakye Kare Udvegna Dibe. That is, for actual Hari Bhajan, if your purpose, if your goal is perfect, if you are speaking all hearts against disciple, all devotees, you have no enmity, nothing inside your heart, no jealousy. Because if you have some sort of jealousy inside you are sitting in Vyasasana, and you think, I have the chance to speak, heavily attack them, then you are committing aparad. Committing aparad. But if I am sitting in asana, I have love, 100% love for you all. If I am going to speak half-truth, then I would be punished by Gauranga. Because half-truth is not truth. I have to speak about the absolute truth, 100%. Half-truth is not truth. So, Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking, those who want to take advantage of this word written there in Chaitanya Charitamrita, that kaimana bakya kari udvegana dibe, those who want to take advantage of this, undue advantage of this word, and they like to misuse this word, they like to mislead people, misguide people. People are misled. They like to misguide people. In that case, very big problem. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very sober, very soft all the time during his preaching, but never Chaitanya Mahaprabhu go into any compromise regarding Siddhanta. Mind it. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's compassion is, without any, measurement. There is no abounded amount of mercy, compassion. But that doesn't mean Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can make any compromise with any, sahaja siddhanta. Not that. That's why I quoted this word from Jagadananda, Prem Vivartha. You must all read Chaitanya, Prem Vivartha. You must read all. 100% you must read. There is Jagadananda speaking. Jagadananda speaking, Sarol hoile golar sikha bujhya loibe. If you are plain hearted, if your heart is parallel with your speech, in that case you can easily understand the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And then again Jagadananda speaking, Gora Rami Mukhe Bolile Nahi Chale, Gorar Achar Goral Vichar Loile Fal Fale. Log Dekhano Gora Bhaja Tilak Matru Dhari Goponete Attachar Gora Dhare Churi. You know? What I speak? Green banana. That's why I request you like to learn Bengali. Very sweet, very nice. You know, Gaurarami. I am doing Garibhajan, Gaur Bhajan. I am Gaur Bhajan. You see, my tilak is there. This, Tulsi, and I have big bat. You want to prove? But Jagadananda want to speak this way, that Gaurarami bolile nahi chale. I am near and dear one, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, you want to prove, but that is not, the excuse. Gaurarami bolile nahi chale. Gaurar vichar loile phalbo. All the teachings of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, all the etiquette is shown by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If you can accept in your life, then you have right to speak that you are a one, you are going to implement the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Asi Chaitanya Manabhishto Sthapitam Jena Bhutale, they are actually near and dear am Gauri. Narottam Thakur, though came late, but still he is the eternal Parshad of Gauranga. Bhaktivinoda Thakur came much late, but still Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the eternal person of, because Gaur Krishna was speaking this way. One day, Bhagavati Ma coming here in Navadvip to take darshan of Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj. He paid dandavat. Gaur Kishore Maharaj was very, very stunned. You coming here? Why? To do marketing here in Navadvip? For marketing you are coming here in Navadvip? No. Then why to take darshan of deity here? No. Then why to take darshan of you? To me? In your home there is Gaur Parsad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You come long way, you are taking trouble. Why you come? Bhaktivinoda Thakur, eternal Parsad of Gauranga is there inside your room. You leave him and come here to take darshan of me? This is speaking. You see, this is the actual Siddhanta. So you see, Gora Rami bolile, mukhe bolile nahi chale. You can speak this, announce. I am big acharya, you see, so much disciples there, so much appliances. But what is concerned to Gauranga? Gauranga less interested. Rupa Raguna, they have nothing. That's why there is a balance Siddhanta, you see. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, I can come back to this Siddhanta, not clear. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Mot mandi dalan bari na karo prayas. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, don't try to make big, big building and temple. Mot mandi dalan bari na karo prayas. Because you are not neutral. You are not sufficiently elevated up to that point. Those who are not neutral, impartial, those who are not impartial, if they make mot, they are bound to go for flattering. And repeatedly I told you, a flattering personality can never become a preaching personality. You are bound to do, come on man, to maintain this, that, so many big. If you are so powerful, if you are neutral, totally 100%. Kesav Goswami was speaking, Nirapekho na hoile dharma na jaye rakshane. To implement this word in action, if all people like to attract me, still I am going to fight with them. I am ready to face that kind of eventuality. Any kind of eventuality coming in front of me, I am ready to stand. Nirapekho na hoile dharma na jaye. If you are not neutral, if you have partiality, then you are going to make some garbage. All over the world, some garbage you can make. And Nityananda Prabhu, you can remember, Namhat in Gadrum, opening Namhatta. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur identifying himself as the sweeper of that Namhatta. What does it mean? Any kind of garbage you like to make, pure Vaishnava, it is the duty of pure Vaishnava to clean. They become very angry. He is not neutral. He is not a man after he is demon. Oh, they can speak like that. They can speak like that. What to do? In Puri, Purushottam Dham, many so-called devotees, they wanted to kill Prabhupada. Because Prabhupada is speaking all about their absolute truth. But they become very angry. So what to do? If you fear to speak the absolute truth, then you cannot become an actual preacher. Only you can collect some money and influence. Only some, garbage. Garbage you can make. So Kesava Goswami speaking, Nirapekho na hoile dharma na jaye rakshane. So dharma, you cannot protect this Vaishnava dharma. What to call about Vaishnava dharma? Even general dharma, with which all social people they are busy, deha dharma, body, a dharma related with this body, it's not permanent dharma, but it's body dharma, mental dharma, manasik dharma, they are all frustrated, they are busy with it. They prove that I am in anugatha, but they cannot do anugatha. Their disease is there. Big disease there, mental disease, manasik dharma. They can do anything like whimsical, madman. They can do. So Kesava Goswami is speaking, to prove that sotra, nirapekshan aile dharma najaya rakshane, if I need to meet any kind of eventuality, if they attract me, I am ready to face that problem. Still, I am not going to ignore this word written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Big problem. Now again I can go back. Gorarami, Gorarami, bolile, mukhe bolile nahi chale. If you can accept all the etiquettes, teachings and etiquettes of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, then and only then you can identify yourself as the eternal person. You cannot identify because you are humble. But people can identify. Myself cannot identify, it's not, humbleness is there. So a Siddhanta is this way, you should think. But you can become, though you cannot feel inside because humbleness is there. But still, So, Logdakhano Gaura Bhajan, you can express that I have tilak, I have bead bag, neck, you know. You can prove. But still, you cannot, you know, get the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Gaura Rami? Logdakhano Gaura Bhajan. Tilak Mato Dhuri. And secretly you are going for all rubbish thing you are committing, different kind of operas, Yashit Sangha Adi you are committing. You think Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cannot see, I can do anything. But Chaitanya arrest you. Chaitanya and his paraphernalia or his, personal associate, they can arrest you readily. Hey, you are doing wrong. So, 360 degree angle mean, what does it mean? There is no impediments. There is no barrier in your darshan. Anywhere you can look, there is clear darshan. Dham, Naam, Parikar, everything you can see clearly, no problem there. So now I like to go back to the original point I started with. What's that? Anur pita charing shirad karuna avatirna kalau samarpata unnata ujjalarasam sabakti sriyam. Harihi purata sundara dhuti gadamba sandivita sada hidayi kandari spurutavasi sachinandana. Today, we like to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's advent inside our heart. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth there, okay. But that's why I speak this sloka first. In starting, I already told you all, to you all, that we are always busy with material darshan. Big problem. That's why we are blind, we cannot see. And I told you, we are busy with shape and design. We are busy to see shape and design, nice shape. First of all, this is called Vedadrik, Mangshadrik. Two type of darshan I told you. This conception is not at all good. If you want to become a nice devotee, pure devotee, you will have to go out of this darshan, material darshan. Yaha yaha netro pare, taha rakta mangshaspure. Wherever you see, nice lady, nice man. This kind of darshan is there till you cannot become a pure sadhu. Not possible. Big problem. So first of all, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not an object so that I can see him. Prabhupada wanted to speak very harsh this way. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not a man and not any object so that I can see. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not an object of my vision. You are very wrong. Jalalambita bhujau kanakavadatu. Golden complexion. I can see very nice. I can put one photo in my room. Okay, you can write. That is also one kind of gratification. Sense gratification. You like to get the taste of your eyes. So nice picture. Those rich people, they are decorating their inside room with nice coloring picture of Krishna. Don't think they are devotee. You are foolish. They are bogi. They like to enjoy the picture of Krishna. But they are idiot. They don't know Krishna is Krishna is not the object of their vision. So that they can see the nice, feature of Krishna. So nice. On the contrary, you should act and behave and do bhajan in such a way so that Krishna, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, become interested to see you. That is called Vedadrik. Vedak, a darshan based on Ved and scriptural support, Guru Varga's kipa. Then you can develop that kind of darshan. Otherwise, in whole life, coming billions of life, you are going to get defeated. Cannot come out successful until and unless you understand this point. So we should act, we should do bhajan, we should, lead our life in such a nice way of devotion, devotional life we should lead in such a way so that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu become interested to see me. Like I told you this example, Dhruva Maharaj, Krishna become very interested, Narayan become very interested to see who is my small devotee. I like to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna become interested. Then Krishna himself going to Madhuban to see my teeny devotee. What kind of nice, you know, I like to see him. But each and every case, everywhere you can find, whenever you are doing the bhajan, Krishna can give darshan to you. That is the way. But in the case of Dhruva Maharaj, it is just opposite. Krishna likes to see his small devotee. So high level, you see. So Prabhupada giving these teachings, if you like to see the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, throughout the year, your Sankirtan Jagya is perfect. If you sacrifice your life for the actual cause of Sankirtan Jagya, already enlightened there in the courtyard of Srivas Pandit, long ago, if you like to sacrifice your life for the actual cause of Sankirtan Jagya, then be sure, today you can take darshan of the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, no wrong in it, 100%. So each and every devotee should feel today, they should do bhajan in such a way, they can see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his lotus feet, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's, you can see inside their heart today. Harihi purata sundaraddhati kadamba sandibhita, sada hidai kandari spurutubha, sisachinandana. That sisachinandana. Now that just changing his color, and Baba, getting the Baba of Radharani and golden complexion of Radharani. He's stealing. He's thief. Actually, everywhere is a Krishna's name is thief. Braje prasidyam navanita chauram. You see? Very nice. Thief, actually. That's why he is stealing. Now, today we are interested to discuss about the actual point. For why we get the, you know, advance, you know, they, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, come here in this material world. That is the main point actually. Why? Because Krishna came already. Though I discussed this point repeatedly, previously also I discussed, that though Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, just now, Rupa Goswami Pada also speaking same way, is Krishna, Nomi Krishna Sarupam. Krishna is there. No, but actually, some change is there. And now, why? Because when Krishna came, wanted to prove so many things, wanted to give so many things, because Gosai Ji also writing this way, Rupa Goswami, Bina Krishna, without Krishna, who is going to distribute prema among creepers? Gulmalata in Vrindavan, they are going to get prema. But Krishna's kripa is limited. Those who are reaching high level, only they can. But Nityananda kripa and Gaur kripa is, you know, open to all. Patra patro vicharanam na kurute na sa param vikshati. Deya diyo va vimarshaka na hi na va kala pratiksho prabhu. Is not going to look anything. You are fit or unfit, you are qualified or not qualified, only you have to cry from heart, simple heart. Gaur Nityananda, you will have to cry this way. Now when Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in Gita, Manmana Bhava Madhijaji Mang Namaskuru, Krishna speaking. Everybody is speaking, very clever. Everybody is speaking. Hey, Piet Andabhattvami, Manmana Bhava Madhijaji, very clever. He is doing all rubbish, rasa, this, that, all with woman. People cannot understand. They cannot understand the mood of Krishna, so high. They can express doubt about Krishna. They like to go into competition with Krishna. Krishna is dancing with, you know, 100 crores Gopika? Satokoti Gopika? So what's wrong if I dance with two Gopikas? They express this kind of... They like to go into competition with Krishna. This is very Krishna crying. I wanted to prove this thing, repeatedly told this point. I told you, come on, I told you. That Mai Bhaktir hi Bhutanam Amrita Taya Kalpate. Mai Bhaktir hi Bhutanam Amrita Taya. I told them repeatedly, but they don't believe. Everybody is speaking, worship me, show devotion to me. I'm very clever. Then Krishna took decision. What wrong is that? I am expressing everything, but they don't, they are not ready to accept me. Madhyaji Mang Namaskuru, I told you repeatedly, I am the only object to be paid, you know, shown, you know, devotion. I am the object of devotion, but they don't believe me. Then Krishna took decision to change his color and Baba and come here. Sochigar was Hindu, Hari Hindu. Hindu means moon, full moon. Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti Radhini Sakti Rasmad Ekatmanu Opi Deho Vedam Gatu Tau Chaitanya Maksham Prakata Madhuna Dayan Chaikam Aptam Radha Babu Duti Subalitam Naomi Krishna Sarupam. Who writing this? Sarup Gosai. The exact reason. Exact reason for why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming. A very, very nice Vedanta discussion here regarding this point when Krishna and Radharani get submerged. It's big, big, high point, sensitive point. Their sensitive point, there's some, you know, discussion was done, gesture, I would say some signal. Where? At the bank of Godavari, you can remember, Raya Ramananda and Mahaprabhu discussing this point. That time, Raya Ramananda could realize this absolutely. We are speaking philosophy. If at all it is in realization inside me, I don't know Gurudev can speak. I have not that kind of audacity to express this way. I am not a philosopher. Only by the mercy of those devotees, there I am taking dust powder from their lotus feet. So I am sitting in Vyasasana speaking that way. I don't know, I have direct realization of not. People can speak. But Raya Ramananda, exact feeling he got that time at the bank of. There Raya Ramananda watching, sometime Radha Krishna, Radharani Panchalika, Krishna embracing Radharani. And sometime watching Radha Govinda separate, sometime you submerge. Then Raya Ramananda watching, what's that? What happens? What I see? What you see? I see you are Krishna and Radha separate, again you submerge. Get this. Actually, jahan jahan netta pare, tahan Krishna spure. It is the usual rules for pure devotees. Wherever they see, they can see their Ishtadev. Wherever they look, it is a, you know, usual, they can take darshan of their Ishtadev anywhere they look. That's why you say, don't try to express, you know, that kind of remark. You are very clever. Speak rightly. Who you are? Ramadevi Prabhu, don't like to cheat me. Please speak me. Who are you? No, actually, you are pure devotee. That's why you are watching this way. Everywhere you see Krishna. No, you speak rightly. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, don't try to express this point to anybody. It is my request. I am Krishna, I am Radha, and so my, I am Gaur. But don't try to express in front of any public. Yes, they can speak, I am mad. So I am. This point, Raya Ramananda could realize directly there. By Radharani, Krishna, and then submerged, melted. Asrishava padaratam pinastumam adarshanad marmahatam karduva jatha tathapa vidhatulam patramatpana rasastu saivana paraham. This should be your heart. If you at all want to enter into Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan, come on man, you cannot understand the level you have to go up. It's not a matter of philosophy. You think you can memorize philosophy? Where you have to go, skyscraper, you can go mad. Where they lie, in what level I am now, you have to go. Then you can. Big point. You have to go up. Then you can realize. Otherwise, at all you are interested to get this Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan, filtered. Raganuga, Rupanuga Bhajan, also Raganuga Bhajan, but a filtered way. Because here only Rupanuga Bhajan is totally filtered. Filtered means not impurity there. Filter, if I use the one word I use, they can find fault. Filtered means more high. Filtered means not there is no impurity. Because Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya is also different kind of rasa there, have their own feature. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing, each rasa has his own point, standpoint. Each rasa, for each rasa, there is one standpoint, a neutral, and unique. For each rasa, there is some unique point, because each point, those who are dasya rasa, they are saying, my rasa is unique and excellent. Well, we are not fighting. Is sakya rasa, if you want to develop that, you also use unique and neutral. You know, but Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, all rasa is there. They are all, you know, excellent in their own point of view. Any devotee, any rasa they are practicing, they are getting. They are actually excellent in their own point of view. But if you are going to stand on neutral platform, then you can find. This madhur rasa is excellent, more excellent. Why? Because in madhur rasa you can get all rasa combined. Akasher gun jano parapara bhute. Kiti apatej marud bom. Kiti apa, you know? Kiti apatej marud bom, you know? No? Five elements, foolish. Bom means space, air, bhumi. Earth, you know, khiti, apa, tej, fire, light, I mean, the five elements. If I go on discussing, you can find each other, this, you know, five elements, each element you, from starting element, the second element if you think, then first element is already there. Second, Kiti apa tej marubam? Second element, the first element. Second element. First element is already there in second. Why, if you think about third element, first and second already there. If you think about fourth element, already first, second, third is already there. This way, akasher gunjano paraparo bhute. Scientific, mathematics, right? So, regarding rasa tattva, madhurasa is topmost. If you are neutral, then you have to speak this way. You are bound to speak that madhurasa is above all. Because in madhurasa, all rasa combined, madhurasa means all rasa is already there. And more excellent. And madhurasa also two division. One is sakaya, svakiya and parakiya. Svakiya, regarding svakiya, you see, those you know, accepted by Krishna, 16,000, 16,000, 108, Mahishis, and all other, Krishna accepted them. They are all, you see, Sakya. They have the right to speak Krishna, Krishna is my husband. But this way, the excellency of rasa you cannot get. Charming feeling you cannot get. Why? This level, in which level you are now at present, if I go on discussing, you cannot realize this one. You have to come up and up. Then you can understand why. Svakiya, if you think that way, then the excellency of Ras cannot get unveiled in front of you. In an extreme point, you cannot get. That's why svakiya, I was speaking about this svakiya parakiya regarding Jiva Goswami path. So many points I wanted to speak, but time was limited. When Jiva Goswami path speaking this point, everybody, you know, become angry. Though everybody means those who are foolish. Jiva Goswami path not at all in line of, in line of Rup and, Sanatan. Why? But he wanted to establish Sakya. He is speaking, the people, they are so idiot, so foolish. But if I get this topic to discuss from all square, all around, I can go on proving different angle, I can go on discussing and prove that Jiva Goswami path is 100% perfect. It is not that Jiva Goswami path wanted to break the rules set by Siddhanta, said by Sanatana and Rupa. Those idiot people speaking this way. They are committing aparadha unto the lotus feet of both. They are doing. Why? Jiva Goswami path knowing this point, svakiya and parakiya, 2 points there. But svakiya is nitya. 100% nitya. Radharani, if you think that way, svakiya is nitya. But parakiya is also nitya. Any kind of bhava expressed in this material Vrindavan, material world, in Vrindavan. Vrindavan is not material. What I mean to say, when Vrindavan coming here in this material world, then there is svakiya and parakiya, you can see. But in Goloka, svakiya and parakiya, both, any rasa here expressed by Krishna in this material world, and devotees they are feeling, that rasa has some their original existence in. Try to get my point. Any rasa expressed here in this Bhauma Vrindavan, any rasa, any feeling by devotees or any feeling Krishna in between them, that bhava, what you are expressing, That originally there, it has to be there. Originally has, what is not there in originally in Golok, how you find here? That is the point. If originally it is not there, you manufacture, you are going to manufacture this Siddhanta here. That Siddhanta is very perfect Siddhanta. What is not originally there, that rasa is impossible here. And in material world, a kind of rasa you are getting, that is called material rasa. You cannot compare this rasa with this transcendental rasa. Anyway, directly or indirectly, rasa is there. Directly or indirectly, anyhow, rasa is there. Without rasa, nobody going to live. Even any creature, like mosquito also getting rasa. He is getting blood from my body. Ah, so nice blood I am taking. He is getting also rasa. The pig, he is also nice stool. Ah, today my big feast. He is getting also rasa. He is also getting rasa. Also one kind of rasa. You are getting sweet ball. Ah, Maharaj, today I get sweet ball. Nice rasa. But that sweetness, what is there in Gauranga Mahaprabhu's Prema Dharma, you cannot get. You are passive. That rasa is totally separate. Material rasa can put you into danger. Material rasa can put you into trouble. Now suppose you are going to get material rasa, but ultimately you are going to be put into prison. Prison, you know? Jail. Maya Devi going to put into jail. So material rasa this is. But anyhow, with the association of pure Vaishnava, is somehow your heart touching that kind of rasa, then you can become mad. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving this test to Rupa Goswami by the bank of Ganga, where? In Allahabad. And after giving this teaching, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Rupa, it is my audacity. See, I cannot express that Krishna is the ocean of, you know, love. Krishna is the ocean of beauty. I cannot express. Only to give you a test. Open your mic and to drip one drop. Just get the test. I am speaking so much thing. Actually, I am failure to give you actual rasa. But still, this is the condition. Krishna is the ocean of transcendental rasa. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, if any devotee going to get one drop of that transcendental rasa, it can inundate total heart. It can inundate your heart totally. Like flood coming. So when flood coming, all up and down inundated everywhere. Where to go? Every place inundated. Yeah. Now Chaitanya when coming, everywhere flood of prema. I am a fallen soul and so idiot, I cannot get one drop of prema. Everybody getting? You see, this is the condition. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu expressing this way. So be sure that without rasa, no creature like to live. Directly or indirectly? Indirect rasa. This is called agri rasa, dirty rasa. And pure rasa is there. So now point is that this Gauranga avatar is special reason to distribute this prema bhakti, exclusive prema bhakti, braja prem. That's why in Chaitanya Charitamrita you can find this point. Ami bina braja prem dita nahi shakti. Ram, Nishinga, Badaho, Darikanath, nobody can give this kind of prema. Only I am bound to come to distribute. This is my personal treasure. This is my personal Gupta Prem. This is my Gupta Prem, secret sampatti, secret property. This is my secret property. So only I will have to distribute this thing. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming and distributes this prema bhakti among all devotees. That time was special because when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here, that was a special bonus period. So anybody who is not having that kind of quality, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving quality, I mean pot at the same time, nectar, both. So now you will have to do bhajan to get that kind of nectar. Though you can find from Narottama Thakur's writing, Nabajiteo de prem don. Without bhajan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu get prem. From that period, that was the time when. But again, Narottama Thakur writing, Sadhan Saran Lila Tahatena Korohela. Kaemone Korea Sushar. One point, if I go on discussion about prem bhakti, you can go mad. You can go mad. What? This kind of feeling there? Yes. One kirtan, one line, if I go on discussion. You can go mad, you cannot realize. Sadhan saran lila tahatena korohela. Kaimone koriya susar. Susar. Try to resolve. Your heart is chanchal. Try to get a settlement of your mind. Kaimane koriya susar means try to harmonize your heart with Guru Vaishnava everything and try to get one solution. Not that still you are going to, well, I don't like it. I like to react this way. You cannot do bhajan. Madman you are. You are speaking, I am following Guru Vaishnava, but your symptom, your character, your activity is not in approving that. Kaimane koriya susar. So whereas Narottama Thakur speaking, sadhan saran, sadhan bhajan. Yesterday I told you I like to clarify this point. Why sravan, kirtan and smaran in one line? Why? Sravan, kirtan and smaran all simultaneously you can get. Why? Because if you are going to hear Sankirtan, somebody has to do Kirtan. Or suppose you are doing Kirtan. Suppose now I am doing Kirtan by your mercy. Well, now calculate. Try to think over and again. When I am sitting in Vyasasana, when I am by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, I am like to glorify the, you know, Siddhanta, glorifying Lotus Feet Gaur, then how I can glorify? If I am not, you know, concentrating my mind, if there is no Saran, I am doing Kirtan. At the same time, I am hearing it. I am doing Kirtan. At the same time, I am hearing. I am hearing. At the same time, now it is my question in front of you. I am doing Kirtan. I am hearing. How is that possible if I am not concentrated on the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Do you think I memorize philosophy and speaking in front of you? What do you think? That means Saran is there. If Saran is there, if concentration is not there and the lotus feet of Gaur and Guru Gauranga, it is quite impossible for me to speak all this secrecy. So it is proved. Savan, Kirtan and Smaran, all simultaneously can be done. I mean, you will have to do. You will have to lead your life in such a way, so it is simultaneously can be done. It is only possible for a pure devotee like Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami, they can do. But for common people, when they are singing, sometimes mind going to Bombay, sometimes in Calcutta, Bangalore, or in Costa Rica, their mind moving. Yes. That's why their saran, their speaking is not, you know, flawless. When Sukadev Goswami speaking Bhagavatam, totally Sukadev Goswami in touch, totally he is in touch with Krishna's lotus feet. Totally, continuously, non-stop. So, Guru Varga, they have non-stop connection with Guru Gauranga. That's why it is possible for them to speak, you know, all the nectarian speech, as Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. All the time speaking Harikatha. Why? He is in touch with. Source is there. Somebody putting question in front of Prabhupada, you are publishing daily Nadia Prakash? Where from you get that kind of news? Daily? Dainik, daily Nadia Prakash, daily, like newspaper. They're putting question in front of Prabhupada, where from you get this kind of new news? Huh? So much news where you are daily going to express, print papers? Prabhupada, come on man, you are mad? Krishna's tripad vibhuti. This world, material world is ekpad. So you are getting so much news and expressing so much newspaper going out. We are speaking about tripad bhumi, Krishna. So you see, there is shortage of any news? So you see, we can express Nadia Prakash, daily Nadia Prakash. So this way, don't think that Guru Varga, they are memorizing philosophy and speaking in front of you. No, to get on, not that. So you see, so Sarup Gosai now speaking this way, Sarup Gosai speaking this way, that Radha Govinda, you know, Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti. In Raya Ramananda expressing this point, is written there in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Radha Govinda, Radharani loving Krishna, Krishna loving Radharani. So their love, you know, distorted, pranaya vikriti. Don't think it other way. Don't take it ugly way. Radha Krishna pranayo la vikriti distorted. Ladini sakti rasmat ekatmano opi bhuvi pura dehuvadam gatautu. This is vital point. Though Radha Govinda inseparable, you cannot cut Radharani from Krishna. One and single tattva. Only there, you know, two, otherwise you cannot, who is going to get taste? Aswadan. Aswadan, aswadan, rasa. The rasa, you going to, somebody need to take the rest of, taste of rasa, and the rasa should be their existence. Who is going to get that rasa? Eh? And the object of rasa? Should be there. So it should be in all in one line. One platform. You don't try to get my point. Rasa, and who is going to enjoy this rasa, take this rasa, and the object of rasa should be in one line. Otherwise you have no right, you have no power to get that rasa. Follow? That's why those devotees should go up. Follow, you see, a secret point. Now, point is that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to get the test. It's after. Another sloka there, I can come. Now, point is that Radha Krishna, their prema, they get distorted. And this way, they submerge. I mean, when Radha Govinda gets submerged, they are feeling gone, they cannot think that I am Radha, I am Krishna. This feeling already gone. You cannot feel it. Through philosophy, I cannot express this Baba. When Asli Shiva Padaratham, when deeply, ekdam, deep, you know, deep feeling, Radha Govinda totally unique and submerged, separate dual conception gone. They cannot feel I am Radha, I am Krishna, gone. It's quite impossible for you to realize. Again, I like to touch that point Jiva Goswami want to prove. Jiva Goswami want to prove that this parakiya is also nitya and svakiya also nitya. If svakiya, those gopikas, they are in Vrindavan and Golok, even in there, I told, those, you know, Gopika, their husband, they cannot realize this point. Inside everybody has Krishna there. So, oh, Krishna is the eternal husband of all, in one sense. But when Gopika is doing rasa or doing, having some connection with Krishna, they can never feel, because their Gopikas, they are feeling that we have husband here, some barrier, oh, husband can know, some, you know, guardian, they can see I am going to meet Krishna. That is the excellency. When river rolling down from Himalaya, if there is impediment, then the river, you know, fire, like fire. If fire, river coming, if big stone is there, then jump, and again, jump, you see. So, Goswami, Pad, Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami, they want to prove, even this love affair with Krishna, if there is no impediment, then there is no charm in this love. Follow, try to get my point. If there is no barrier, it's very straight, I can go and love with Krishna. Exchange love. No, if there is barrier, then their love become have some firm determination, like river. I must meet Samundar, sea, because ultimate goal of all seas to meet with seas. Without any control, they are going to meet seas. This is the ultimate goal. So now point is that here in this material world, when there's Gopika, they are having some love relation with Krishna, also they have some fear. My husband is there, some guardian is there, so there's big problem. This is one kind of charming. It's one kind of charming in the way of love with Krishna. But at the same time, I would say, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking this way, that they can feel their husband is there. Yes. Lalita Sakhi, his husband is there. Bishakha, husband is there. All Sakhi, they have husband. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, they actually, in Golok Vrindavan, if you go back, they have that kind of feeling only. Try to point out. In Golok Vrindavan, originally, there if you go back, there you find those Gopika fearing, oh, my husband can watch me. But husband is not there. Follow? Only that feeling is there. Maharaj, I do flavor. Only that feeling is there. Feeling is nitya. I mean the rasa, that rasa is nitya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur proving this thing there in Golok Vrindavan, is a feeling, oh, I can speak to Kamsa. We can go to Kamsa, Mathura and speak. That Kamsa is not there. Kamsa is not there in Golok. Only that kind of feeling is there. So in Goloka, that feeling is nitya. That's why Sakya and Parakya both nitya. Sakya Bhava, I proved just now. They have this feeling. That feeling, when Vrindavan coming here in this material world, it take a gross form. Like Gopa. So we have a husband. So in this material world takes a gross form, body. Actually in fine form it is there, in gold. So Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to prove this point to save you all from danger. Because material people, they are so fallen, they cannot understand the love affair of Krishna. They can express doubt. They can try to imitate Krishna. Krishna doing rasa with Satakoti Gopi. I can go. If I do with two Gopikas, what problem? This is very bad. That's why Gauranga Mahaprabhu coming to show the exact feeling Krishna wanted to exhibit you. But you misunderstood Krishna. That's the same thing in GauraLila we are going to get. Follow my point. In GauraLila, that's why repeatedly I speak under the guidance of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur that GauraLila is the exact explanation, total explanation of Krishna Lila. If you have the chance to misunderstand Krishna, but you have no chance to misunderstand Gaura, even Gaura in GauraLila, when Gauranga Mahaprabhu someday full of ecstatic feeling, Gopi, 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 some student and some outside boys, they coming, they suggest, why you speak Gopi? You can speak, you should speak Krishna. What use you speak? Then Gaura become very angry, with a stick there to beat them. That is a, you know, Vikriti, distorted form of lava. Don't think Gauranga Mahaprabhu want to beat them out of some anger, angry attitude. Not that. But those boys, they couldn't understand. They fly and they make a big meeting and speaking, well, Chaitanya, who is Gaur? Huh? Who is Nimai? He like to beat us? We can make a group and beat him totally. Yes, they took decision to beat Nimai. How big audacity he like to beat us all. Then at the same time it is written Chaitanya Bhagavat, when they took decision to beat Nimai, all the education gone, vanished from heart. Like Kampur. Kampur, you know? They study for long day, long year, 10 years, 7, 8 years, all educational quality all gone. They cannot remember anything. They cannot remember, all gone. Because they took decision to beat Nimai. Now Nimai crying, I came here in this material world to give some unique thing. But they misunderstood me. They wanted to beat me. But it's very bad. So I can do one thing. I can take sannyas and go door to door. Those who wanted to beat me, I can go to their door to for begging. So anyway, they can, their heart can get melt. That Nima is big pandit, so much high elevated. Now he is taking sannyas for expressing humble attitude. We have no right to beat him now. Rather, we must love him because he is expressing humble attitude. Sannyas means humble attitude. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, "Well, I came here to distribute this unique treasure property. I wanted to give them, but they misunderstood me. Well, I must take sannyas to save them." So that is the reason. So Krishna took decision to come here in this material world with a mood to give a prema fluently, freely. That's why Gaur came. When Gauranga going towards Ganga, towards Bengal, from Sikhetra, then it is written there, Pratap Rudra king and all his wives, they are sitting in on, you know, elephant, and from distant place, this Gauranga is sannyas. For sannyasis, it is prohibited to watch one woman and watch rich people, king, it is prohibited. But this one secret philosophy is there. It is open teaching. One secrecy is there. What secrecy? That doesn't mean that sannyasi cannot go for preaching and they cannot see. That is prohibited. Why? If you have some enjoying mood. That is. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to put this. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to put the yardstick. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to put the yardstick just standard. You watch and go. And Guru Bhargava all explained this. My son, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu expressed this mood this way. Actual meaning is this, that you should not have any kind of enjoying feeling. If you can leave all my mother sitting here, I have 100% right to see them. If I can see all my daughters sitting, they are all Radharani sitting in different form. So why? It is prohibited. Then I should leave this place and go to solitary place to do bhajan. I am very happy. I am going to take darshan of all this different form Radharani coming in front of me. Because I have no eyes to see Radharani. I have chance, right? So I should see this way. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu putting this standard to make me very careful. You should be very careful. Give me warning. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Nityananda? We are doing preaching under the guidance of Nityananda. Overall Nityananda is there. So Nityananda going every home to home. So every home Nityananda going, there is Mataji. If I go to your home to for begging, Mataji can come to give begging? Who can give bhiksha? Pitaji is outside for money. Pitaji always outside, so Mataji giving. So what problem is? Any bhiksha given to any sannyasis, even in Raman you can say Ravan came to get bhiksha. Who? Sita Devi giving bhiksha. It is a system. So Nityananda, what is the bhiksha of Nityananda? Nityananda going door to door, they are meeting. Some Mataji may be there, some Pitaji may be there. Nityananda was speaking, Amare kinya laho bhajo GauraHari. Try to purchase me and speak GauraHari. That is all, that is my bhikkha. Only this bhikkha I want to get. Amare kinya laho bhajo GauraHari. Bolo GauraHari. Bhajo GauraHari. Only this is my bhikkha. I am not begging for rice and chapati, nothing. Only this bhikkha I like to get. But Amare Kinyal tried to purchase me and tried to speak GauraHari. You have to speak this way. That is bhikkha. So we are doing, because Namhatta I told you, Nityananda Prabhu opening Namhatta here in this, in a Gadroom. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur identifying himself as the sweeper of that Namhatta. Bhaktivinoda Thakur Nama identify himself as a sweeper of Namata. What does it mean? Bhaktivinoda Thakur cannot allow any kind of dirty thing you like to put there, throw there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur cannot allow you. Hey! Why you are putting dirty thing? I am cleaning repeatedly. So now Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, they are crying. Why you are putting dirty thing here? We are all cleaning under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Yeah, you are making dirty. What does it mean? Again, I can go back to that philosophy. Mat mandi dalanbari na kore prayas. Don't, if you are not neutral and elevated, don't try to make temple and big building. It is a one kind of bondage for you. Because you are not in neutral level. You cannot express bhakti if you are elevated. Also, at the same time, it is written in Bhagavatam, Krishna speaking in front of Buddha. In Bhagavatam Maharaj, it is written, Krishna speaking in front of Buddha, Buddha Prabhu. What is written? Man mandir kare dhiram. Try to make big temple. Krishna speaking to Buddha. Buddha, try to make big build, meaning temple, not building. Big temple. Krishna giving advice to Uddhava. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, don't try to make. What is the, you cannot find in harmony, big fighting there. You can misunderstand Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Right? So what Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak, I already told, Keshav Goswami was speaking, if you are neutral, you know, if you have neutral darshan, no partiality. Because bonded soul, 100% their partiality. 100% they cannot go out of the disease. They cannot go out of this disease. It's a must. It's one kind of disease, it's partiality. He is my group. He is that group. Big fighting in temple. Why Maharaj is coming to do bhajan? Why taking sannyas? If at all you are going to fight, why not you fight in home? Dirty thing you are doing. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur again coming to clean. Then Namahatta. Namahatta mean where Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava doing Sankirtan. That is called Namahatta. At present now, it is Namahatta. If we are at all under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada doing. So Namahatta, there should be clean. Always you try to. You also, Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada speaking, we all have this common duty. Yesterday you were speaking this point. Maharaj, some people think cleaning dham is actually some material. Who told? Foolish. Cleaning dham, cleaning this Sankirtan Jagya place, Namahatta, is material action? Material job? Foolish? No. It's bhakti. You must do. If anybody is speaking all rubbish, hey, why you are speaking this Siddhanta? Why? This Siddhanta is Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. This is your duty because you are Gaudiya Sannyasi. If you don't speak, if you try to go into some reconciliation with that Maharaj who is speaking all rubbish, then you are going to hell. I told you that same thing. Jo bhakti nairahitam anayana srinatija. Who is speaking all rubbish? Who is going to hear that thing? Both of them going to hell for infinity pure. It is written. So it is your duty also. All Mataji, those who are hearing this perfect Siddhanta, it is your duty. If you find somebody speaking wrong, you say, no, this is not. This is Siddhanta. Why are you speaking wrong? Excuse me, if you never mind. Don't fight with them. Never mind. I heard this Siddhanta from Bhaktivinoda. What you think is speaking this way? This is a very humble attitude, you can speak this way. So, Radha, so Mat Mandir, if Prabhupada making, Prabhupada going against Bhaktivinoda Thakur? No. For Prabhupada 100% it is perfect. For Keshav Goswami Maharaj perfect. It is perfect, it is right for them. But for other people, common people, it is not good. They cannot go up to that level to express neutral, feeling. They cannot express a weak problem. So Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti now get distorted. Are this feeling you cannot get in this stage. As Radha Govinda totally submerged, they have dual conception gone, they cannot feel. So high class feeling, Radharani cannot think that I am Radharani, Krishna cannot think I am Radhi. Rai Ramananda speaking this truth in front of, you know, all devotees. Naham so Ramano, Nasa Ramani, this very secret thing I can discuss after. No feeling. Duho Milone, they two get submerged, they get unified, there is one magical catalytic factor is there. Nobody can feel this thing. There is magic spell. That thing you will have to realize, very. Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti Ladini Shakti Rasma, Ladini Shakti. And try to remember this point, without Ladini Kripa, without the Kripa of Ladini Shakti, you cannot enjoy hearing Harikatha, Kirtan, Parikram, doing Harinam Sankirtan, nobody, nothing. Ladini, it is a duty of Ladini to give you enjoyment. It is the duty of Ladini Shakti to give you enjoyment. You can get more and more inspiration and enjoyment to go for further bhajan. Ladini Shakti. And Sandhini Shakti can give you, you see, this Guru Varga and this, that, Dhamma, this, Sandhini. This Sandhini. Duty, if you can grow this relationship with Sandini, oh, this is Dham. You can realize, oh, I am in Dham. Sandini Shakti. Guru Varga. He is not material man. He is Guru. Material you can see is all like ordinary people. Gurudev going to bathroom, Gurudev taking prasad, all like me. So don't try to go too near. It is my request to you, don't try to go too near to a pure devotee. Then you can lose everything. You can find fault. Somebody, some devotee wanted to take darshan of Bhakshidat Bhavaj Maharaj, taking permission from Prabhupada. Prabhupada said, no! Don't go. You cannot understand his feeling. If you can go and misunderstand, you can go to hell. So don't try to go too near to Guru Vaishnava. Sometimes you can find there with coping, sitting. Oh, you coming? They change dress with gamcha. They're sitting sometime. Doing some seva. If you suddenly go to meet them, they can close door and change dress. Some Mataji coming to meet, some Pitaji coming to meet. This way actually. So it is good. Don't try to reach too near to a pure devotee. Then you can find fault with them. Big problem. Distance. Try to keep a safe distance. Like driving, safe distance. Safe distance, you see. So this is very dangerous. So pure Vaishnava, their activities you cannot realize. Their bodily defects you can find. Some body defect is there, you can find. This is not good. Rupa Goswami Bhat in, you know, is writing so many things I can discuss after. So this way, this feeling is out of your imagination, this feeling. Naham so Ramano, Nasa Ramani. And so they get submerged, this very vital point. Now this, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, now when coming, sometime expressing the mood of, you know, Gopikas, Radharani's bhav, you know, sometime expressing Krishna's bhav. Forehand, every, you know, expressing here. In Sivas, Angan, taking everything. Ishwar Bhav. It is called Ishwar Bhav. Mixed. First in starting, you get a mixed Bhav. After that, no mixed Bhav. First of all, in starting, you get a mixed Bhav. In Siddhar Angan, all Salgram putting in lap and sitting. Hey, Sivas! Whom you are worshipping? I am here, look! Sitting with all Sargami. Then Siva started worshipping him with Ganga Jal, this, that. Where is Siddhar? Where is Advaita? Call them! let them see as my feature. That's mixed feature. After that, go faint again. They ask him, Sivas, Gadadhar, what kind of problem there with me? Why I am faint? I cannot. Something happened, I think. I cannot remember what happened. Expressing this way. The first mixed bhav. The mixed bhav gone. After that, again took sannyas. Then you can meet Radha bhav, Gopika bhav. Radha bhav directly cannot show because people cannot take the post of Radharani. Very secret Siddhanta. I cannot take the post of, you know, Lalita Sakhi. Very secret Siddhanta, I can discuss this one. I cannot take this very, you know, like demon. You can follow him. Mayavadi. Radharani Guru. Though there is no fault with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself Radharani. But still, it's Manjari Bab expressing, you see. So this way, to distribute this prema, which is only available inside the cell of Vrindavan, in Vrindavan, prema, that prema, now you have the facility to get that kind of prema. Gopi prem. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give through Sankirtan. Also Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to do Sankirtan there in Nilachal when took sannyas. Through Sankirtan, every time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove your Sankirtan, if your Sankirtan is 100% perfect, very shortly you can feel that Nam Brahma himself can express Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. In this Harinam, Mahamantra, you can find all Krishna's Leela, everything you can feel inside this Mahamantra. Inside this Harinam Mahamantra, today you go on doing if perfection, if someday if you attain perfection, automatically you can find in Vyasasana, you are doing Harinam, you can find everything you can see through Harinam. You can see Radha Govinda there, all their pastimes, everything, all paraphernalia, dham, everything you can see. Very secret. You can see everything. Everything. But first of all, a devotee should follow pure Vaishnava to get the actual teaching. What Jagadananda wanted to speak. Saral hoile. Saral means you cannot never become saral. Until and unless you can prove 100% Saranagati unto the lotus feet of God. It is math like mathematics. It is like mathematics. If 100% Saranagati is near, what is concerned to us? That kind of straightness is not allowed. Material people can have that kind of simplicity, straightness, but that's not here a special thing. Here this, what kind of, if submission is not there, then your, you know, saral haile, then you are not saral. Saral, if you are saral, I mean, if your 100% submission is approved, I mean, by Guru Varga, and is you are getting, then and only then, your Harinam, you can chant Harinam and Sankirtan, everything. Then after that, you can get this facility. That Harinam can express everything in front of you. Harinam can express everything in front of you. This is the system. Now actually, today is the appearance day of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I like to discuss sometime after I can also Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kidrisho Vanaiva Svadda Jainad Bhuta Madhuri Ma Kidrisham. This way, this sloka is very important. There is three reasons for why. One is Radhaya Pranaya Mahima. Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima. After that, what? Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima. Kidrisho Vanaiva Svadda Jainad Bhuta Madhurima. Kidrisham Madhyaha. Sokhyam Chasya Madhana Bhavataha. Kidrisham Vayati Lobhad. Sarma Samajani Sachigarva Sindhu Hariindyu. It's very nice sloka. But I need time to explain. I can only today, what time?
10.
So I can now, you know, skeleton discussion I can speak today. After some time I can speak in details, okay? If you are lucky, then you can hear it, of course. 3 point, vital point. There is so many reason. When Krishna coming, each and every action, it is Vrindavan Das Thakur writing, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing, there is so many countless reason. There is countless reason for why Krishna coming, when any avatar coming. But there is vital 3 points. One is, Sri Radhaya Purnaya Mahima Kidrisho. Radharani loving me so much. What kind of, you know, but what kind of this love? I cannot, her feeling is so high, I cannot understand. What is there in me? Madhya, inside me, what is the excellence there in me? Because I myself cannot get this test. What is there inside me so that Radharani feeling this kind of, Madhya, feeling this kind of. So these 3 things. So for this reason, Krishna thinking that if I am Krishna Supreme Lord, okay. But still, if Ashadan, Ashadya and Rasa, 3 separate existence, if not there, then who can get test? How can get test? What is the object of test? I told you, Devavedam Gatau Tau. I told you this slogan. Only for this reason, Ekaki Noiva Ramate. In Upanishad, one sloka is there. Ekaki Noiva Ramate. If I am alone, how I can get enjoyment? Ekaki Noiva Ramate. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Ekaham Bahuswam Upanishad. I am one and unique, but I like to become, to enjoy love. If there is no devotee, if there is no Radharani, what is the value of Krishna? If there is no Radharani, if there is no Gauriya devotee, who is Gaur? Who can know? Who is going to know who is Krishna? Who is Gauranga? Nobody can know. Very excellent. And the procedure, how to satisfy these 3 desires. 3 desires inside, strong desire, I would say. To satisfy this strong desire, Krishna took decision to steal the body color, golden complexion of Radharani and Baba from Radharani. Then he took, here, came in the form of Gauranga. I told you long time before, you can remember, if Radharani's bhav is stolen, Radharani left. Radharani's bhav stolen. That is Godadar. And another Godadar, they are Godadar Das in Aryadaha in Calcutta, you can. Godadar Das. That Godadar Das is the effulgence, light coming out of Radharani. That Shakti took the form of Gadadhar Das. This way, if I go on discussing this Gaura Lila, you can go mad. Just mad. You cannot understand. This day or night, taken prasadam or not, thirsty is there or not. This way. So, I have no envious attitude with any acharya here in this matter. Don't try to misunderstand me. Somebody can put question, Maharaj, why you are not chanting this? It is my request to you, you try to find out this reason for why I cannot get, and I feel comfortable to sing, whereas I can feel comfortable anywhere you can take me. There's some secrecy is there. I can think, I can feel that you are intelligent. If you can try to get the answer yourself, if you put in front of me, I need to speak answer, you can think otherwise. I love everybody. Not that I hate somebody. Sometimes I avoid. Sometimes it is a rule. I like to avoid somebody. Because there's Sankirtan, if I like to do purely, then I will have to do it. It's a procedure. So, One thing I forget yesterday to speak. One thing. That is that, Mamgachi, Madhuddum Deep, is Bandirbhat. Bandirbhat. I don't speak. I forget because so many things to speak. Of Dhamma Parikram. Another point I was expressing doubt, I miss. Yes, you can remember. That Gauranga Mahaprabhu